Okay, assalamualaikum and very good morning. Okay, today we will continue with our next lecture, which is on the mechatronics, okay, electrical actuating system, which is part number 3. Okay, so before this, you have learned on the DC motor, which is the brush one. And then for today, we will continue with on the brushless permanent DC motors. And also the final one is on the stepper motors, on the stepper motor specifications, and also how to can control the stepper motor. Okay, so just a recap. Okay, a motors. Okay, the final element of the control system that can give actions. We have will be driven by the AC or DC motors, and for the DC motors, they will be have a brush type and also the brushless types. Okay, you have learned on the brush type, and also for the brush type, we have a permanent magnet stator and also electromagnetic stator. Okay, so how about the brushless type? Okay, so today we will go through this type of DC motors. Okay, just a recap also. Before this, I just briefly explain to you on the difference between this brush and also the brushless DC motors. Okay, so for the brush DC motors, we know that we have the rotor, okay, the winding one at the center, and the permanent magnet stator at the surroundings. Okay, so why they need a communicator and also the brushes? Because it is to reverse the current through each of the ammeter coil. Okay, so that's the needs of these two additional elements. But from this rotating, they will providing a wear where brush needs to change, okay, and commutator needs to be resurfaced. That's the a big disadvantage of the brush DC motors lah. Okay, so for the brushless DC motors, so we have a difference design where the rotor or as a magnet in the center, and the stator, which is a winding here. Okay, so basically his reacts on the magnet is explained as opposite and equal force due to Newton's third law, where force given is equal to force of the actions. Okay, to this motor that can provide the rotating. Okay, so the current carrying the inductors are fixed and the magnet will move lah. Okay, it's opposite to brush. Okay, as a magnet will be moved, will be rotate here, but for this case the armature that will be rotate and the magnets will be fixed. That's the one of a difference between these two type of DC motors. Okay. Okay, this is the real on the application of the DC motors brushless, okay, in the floppy hard disk. Okay, we can see it's a winding on the stator here. Okay, so for the brushless permanent DC motors, okay, this is another some additional informations. It consists of a sequence of stator coils and a permanent magnet. Okay, this is a stator coils of A, B, and C, for example, and permanent magnet at the center lah, which this feels not to sort. Okay, so the current of the stator coils is electronically switched by the transistor lah. Okay, we have a transistor that can switch to the different stators here. The force always acting magnet will cause a rotating in the same direction lah. Okay, will give a rotating of the permanent magnets. And the sensor that have in the stator coils will detect the position of the rotor here lah, so that it can give informations to the transistor to switch on the movement of the magnet rotor. So it's a quiet and high speed due to lack of brushes lah, due to there's no wear and no frictions that contact to the brushes. So it provide a less noise and it can provide a more high speed movement. Okay, this is the detailed information on how we have these three type of sensor A, B, and C, and coil A, B, and C. that's related to the previous pictures, okay? So we can have this is table you need to know, you need to understand on the rotor position from 0 degree to complete of 360 degree of the movement of rotations, okay? And the sensor activation lah, okay? So we also we have the sensor activation. 0 means it's not activate, and 1 is the sensor is activated. Okay, so the transistor on also is given the flow of the current, for example, from A plus to B minus. Okay, for example, for 0 degree from the A plus to the B minus, on how the flow of the current go through. Okay, so we see here, this is example of 0 degree. Okay, when we have a current flow from the A plus to the B minus, which is sensor activation of sensor C only. Okay, and also for the 60 degree, we can see the transistor of A plus here is activated to the C minus, which sensor B and C is now activated. Okay, you can go through also which this another degree of movement to understand in detail complete rotating of the this brushless DC motor. Okay, move on is a stepper motor. Okay, which is we can produce rotating through the equal angles. Okay, the means of produce rotation through equal angles, that means is step movement. Okay, so for example, you give a one pulse signals, it can rotate of a 6 degree. Of movement, for example, and if you give 60 pulse, so you just multiply by 6, it can complete of 360 degree of rotating. Okay, so for the stepper motor, they will have a 3 difference, which is reluctance. Okay, this one, the first one, reluctance, and also the permanent, and also the hybrid. Hybrid is the combination of reluctance and also the permanence. Okay, so for the reluctance, this is the top view. Okay, we have a rotor here, okay, and stator. Okay, as a user for the brushless one, so the poles for the rotor is basically less than the stator lah. So we can have 1, 2, 3, 4 poles for the rotor, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the stator. So basically is we provide a one pulse of the signals to the about 7.5 degree or 15 degrees of movement lah for this one of the reluctance stepper motor. Okay, so how about the permanent one? Okay, the permanent magnet stepper motor, it have a stator with 4 poles. Okay, here each pole has a field winding and opposite pairs of poles. So for example, if you have seen here, okay, let's say we try to understand the movement, which is this is the first step, second, third, and final step of the movement. Okay, so we can see that, so this is knot and sort, and this is sort and knot. So we attract to this field, okay, so that it move here. And then after you complete to this position, from these knots to these positions, so that it will attract again to these sorts and knots to move here. And then it's go to the third one at these locations. Again, it's attract to this poles. Okay, and final position is going to this one lah. Okay, it's going towards to this attract to knots, and also this will attract. Okay, so it's be complete about the one cycle of 360 degree. Okay, that's how the permanent step magnet stepper motor functions. Okay, so the rotor is permanent magnet, okay, of course, and if current supply, you should rotate about 45 degree position or step for this one. Okay, okay, so move to next is on the stepper motor specifications. Okay, this is some terms that you need to understand for the stepper motor specifications. Okay, this is graph of top against the speed. Okay, this is a zero position. Okay, the first one is on the phase. Okay, What is phase actually is a number of independent windings of the stator lah. Okay, so the more on the how complicated the windings will determine the phase of the motor. So the for example the permanent one previously is a two phase motor. The third phase is on the reluctance and the fourth phase is provide a more higher applications lah. Okay, this is based on the how complicated and type of windings is determine the phase. And then we have a step angle, which is the angle through which rotors rotates for one switching change for the stator coils. Okay, this is step angle lah. How many angles that the move lah. Angle through which rotors rotate for one switching change for the stator coils. Okay, and the third term is the holding torque. Okay, is a maximum torque that can be applied to power the motor without moving it. Okay, this is the holding torque. Okay, the maximum torque that can be applied to power the motor without moving it. Okay, it's a starting torque lah basically. Okay. Okay, for the step motor specifications. Okay, we know that there's some terms also. The pull-in torque here. Okay. Is actually the maximum torques against which motor will start and reach the synchronizer. Okay, the maximum torques against which motor will start. Okay, and then the pull out torques is a maximum torque that can be applied to a motor running at given stepping rates without losing the screen synchronizer lah. Okay, this is a pull out torques, so we can have the plot here. And also the pull-in rate is also related to the pull-in torque lah. The maximum switch rate that it which loaded motor to start. This is the keyword lah, motor to start without losing the step. And finally the pull-out rates, this is switching rates at which the loaded motor will remain in synchronism as the switching rate is reduced. Okay, this is pull-out rates is related to the pull out torque. Okay, so there's another, the final definition is a slew rate, slew range. This is the range of switching rates between the pull in and pull out which the motor run in a synchronizer. Okay, so that's the sum of term that you need to understand for the step motor operatings. Okay, so move to the final one is on the stepper motor control. Okay, so the stepper motor control is how you can control a stepper motor. Okay, the solid state electronics such as the transistor here, okay, will help and use to switch the DC supply between the pairs of the stator windings. Okay. For example, we have a second phase motor as a permanent, okay, permanent stepper motor. Actually, it's a bipolar motor. Okay, has the four connecting wires to generate a switching sequence and driven by the H circuit. So this is the H circuit that is similar to what you have learned for the brush motor. Also, they have a H circuit. But for the stepper motor, it's have a more complicated lah. It's a bipolar. Okay, so this is the table of how it can operate here. Okay, like we see more details on this one. Okay, this is for the step number one. Okay, where we have a voltage in here, and it's go to the on number one and four, transistor one. Okay. And transistor 4, where transistor 2 and 3 is off, and transistor 5, the same voltage is delivered to transistor 5 and 8, where 6 and 7 is off. So for the next step, the front one is maintained and the latter one is changed. Okay, where in this case 1 and 3, 4 is on and 2 and 3 is off as a step 1. But 6 and 7 is switched on and 5 and 8 is switched off now. Okay, So for the next step, this the letter one it will be maintained, okay, and the front one will be changed. Okay, you can see the slide after this, okay, where in this case, step number 3, 1 and 4 is off, and 2 and 3 is on. Yeah, okay, and it's in a continuity. Yeah? Okay, we go back to 1, where if one to change to the next, this one is maintained, okay, but if you want to go to the next one, this part is maintained. And finally, on the step 4, the first one is maintained and it changed back to the second one lah, which means that in this case the final one, the 2 and 3 is on, okay, and the 5 and 8 is on, okay. This is the same as the first step one lah. You can see back here as the 5 and 8 is now on, okay. So you need to understand lah the how it's react to control the stepper motor in this case. Okay, so before I close end this class, so maybe you can have a try on this example. Okay, if a stepper motor has a step angle of 7.5 degree, okay, what the digital input rate in pulse per second is required to produce a rotation of n equal to 10 revision per second. So this is some of example how we can provide a very good working example and also the bad working example that may you have lost your marks, which is a working steps. Okay, so we have a step angle here. Okay, the number F, we know that's a complete rotation is 360. If we divide by 7.5, we know that it need 48 steps to complete a 1 revisions. Okay, as if a speed is increased to 10 revisions, how many inputs pulse per second we need? So we just have a 40 step multiply by 10 so that we get a result of 480 pulse per second that we need to input so that it can provide the movement as a given by the question lah. Okay, so this is basically some of example how you can get full marks for the answer lah. Please properly do and give a more detailed answer step instead of this one. Okay, this may have right, but you will have lost some marks on because of these simplifications. Okay, okay, so that's the end of the class. Okay, this is some of the exercise that you can do by yourself, because this is mostly example that's similarly as I shown before, how many step pulse per second that will processor need to output per second to a stepper motor if the motor is a give output of 0.25 revision per second, which has a step angle of 7.5. okay, and exercise number 2, what is the difference between the brush type DC motors and brushless DC motor? Okay, what is the advantage of the brushless DC motor compared to brush type DC motors? This is also explained in the beginning of the lectures just now. Okay, maybe you can try by yourself. Okay, that's all for the class. Thank you very much.